to this video on constructions. In our previous video, we discussed the construction of a triangle. Construction of such a triangle, where the length of the base side, a base angle, and the difference of the other two sides is given. We divided the difference of the sides in two cases. Case 1, when the side formed from the base angle is larger than the other side. And case 2, when the side formed from the base angle is smaller than the other side. And in the previous video, we understood the construction according to case 1. In this session, we will understand the construction of a triangle according to case 2. Let's again see what is case 2. Suppose we have a triangle PQR, where the length of the base side QR and the measure of the base angle Q is given, and the difference of the sides PR minus PQ is given, where PR is greater than PQ. Friends, here you can see that side PQ formed on the base angle Q is smaller than the side PR. This is the difference between case 1 and case 2. So let's see the steps for construction of a triangle like this. Step 1. First of all, with the help of a scale, draw a line segment QR of the given measure. Step 2. With the help of a protractor, by making an angle Q from the vertex Q, draw a ray QX. Step 3. We will now extend QX in the opposite direction and name this ray as QX dash. Step 4. With the help of a compass, taking a distance equal to the difference of the value of PR minus PQ, mark an arc on QX dash. Step 5. We will now join the points S and R. Step 6. Draw the perpendicular bisector of line segment SR. And we name this perpendicular bisector as YZ. You can see that YZ is intersecting line XX dash at point P. Step 7. Now we will join points P and R. And friends, in this way, the formed triangle PQR is the required triangle which we wanted to draw. Now let's check our construction. For this, we will have to show that the difference of the two sides PR minus PQ will be equal to the given difference SQ. We see that point P is equidistant from points S and R because this point P is located on the bisector of the line segment SR. Therefore, PS will be equal to PR. Let's call this equation as equation 1. And the line segment PS is formed by joining two line segments PQ and SQ. So PS equals PQ plus SQ. We can write it like this as well. Or SQ equals PS minus PQ. Using equation 1, we can write it like this also. SQ is equal to PR minus PQ. That is, the length of side SQ is equal to PR minus PQ. Therefore, our construction is correct. So friends, with this, let's end this video. In this session, we learned the construction of a triangle where the length of the base side, one base angle, and the difference of the other two sides is given. Now let's meet in the next video with some questions related to this construction. Thank you.